So I'm Anirudh Singh, I work at Canaan Partners. We're an early stage technology focused venture capital fund. We're a 23-year-old fund headquartered out of Silicon Valley. In the US, we look at the technology and healthcare segments. And in India, we look at technology enabled and managed services segments. Personally, I am fairly excited about e-commerce, education technology, payment systems, and broadly, the reasons for this is that, of course, we've been seeing a lot of companies which are coming up in these spaces, and also the fact that there is a huge untapped market in India. So, if we talk about payments, payment solutions, for example, there's a 600 million user base in India. Of course, a large portion of that has a very, very low cost mobile phone. Nevertheless, there is still immense distribution, which is, so to say, untapped. So we believe there are lots of services, and a large part of this segment does not have access to the most basic amenities like electricity, housing, water, but they have a mobile phone. So that's one reason why we're excited about mobile payments, because at the end of the day, there's a large unbanked population. There's a large population which doesn't have access to a line of credit. So the success of microfinance has shown that how important financial inclusion is for this kind of a segment. Talking about e-commerce, I think Flipkart has shown the way that if you give the right kind of services to internet users in India, they will be more than willing to transact online. I think at the end of the day, of course, it's about the kind of products and services you sell, but it's also about execution. And Flipkart, through its focus on execution, has proven a point. And it has validated our thesis that there is a huge market in India. Of course, there are hurdles. Internet penetration is low, and propensity to pay online is not very high. But I think if we see interest, we should be seeing some interesting business models coming up in the segment, and we should see them getting traction. Education, again, one of the very critical areas in the ecosystem in India today. A parent might not have enough money, but he will still ensure that he spends money on his child's education. They will try and get the best possible for their children. So I think that's and within that, technology would have a very important role to play going forward in the future. I think the key problems there are that it's a very fragmented market, and how do you come up with a technology that is critical yet is not trying to replace a classroom and the teacher, and is also trying to and can also solve the problem of the market being highly fragmented. But yes, so broadly, these are the three areas which I'm personally very interested in. And as I said, as a fund, in India, we look at technology-enabled and managed services companies. By technology, I mean companies which use technology as a platform to scale up and use that as a barrier to entry. A very recent investment which I worked on was Naptol. Naptol is a home shopping network and a comparison shopping website. Another very recent investment by Canaan was Equitas Microfinance. So broadly, this is the kind of work which I and Canaan, we have been doing, and our interests in India. Social media is definitely a very, very interesting space. In fact, I'd like to speak about an article which I read on TechCrunch the other day. It talked about how Silicon Valley is now not focusing on solving the world's problems. Earlier, it used to, the innovations and the companies which you saw coming out of Silicon Valley, they tried to solve real problems. They tried to help the world in more tangible ways, perhaps. But today, you know, the focus is more on companies like Facebook, Twitter, Foursquare, and, you know, so on and so forth. There is, of course, focus on other companies as well. Clean tech is very big, but there is a large amount of focus on social media as well. So the article stated that Silicon Valley is just trying to come up with feel-good companies, but not really addressing something serious. And I think that article couldn't have been more off the mark. Reason for that is, I'll give you a couple of statistics here. Google plays in a $60 billion market, which is essentially advertising through its website. While Facebook plays in a $600 billion market, and I'll tell you why. What Google does is only advertise on the basis of their users' past history, past search histories, and what the person has, and what the person's search term was. Essentially, very, very, the data is not as precise as a marketer would want. A large chunk of the marketing still lies in the, you know, in brand marketing. So Madison Avenue today doesn't focus on Google, because if I want to, for example, advertise Louis Vuitton, I may or may not do that on Google, because a person who's typing handbags, you know, he or she could want a very low cost handbag, or maybe it's something else. But if I'm there on Facebook, I'll know the person's age, I'll know their which country they live in, I'll know what sort of professions, if any, they are in. I'll know what, you know, economic strata they fall in. I'll have all that data. And that is Facebook plays in. And that is a $600 billion market. So I think it's such a huge channel to actually, optimize, you know, make the entire, spending in terms, you know, marketing and sales and marketing spending efficient. I think it's very, so this is where social media comes in. Second thing is, I think at some point, everybody will want to replicate their networks or their life offline. They'll want it online as well, which is why, you know, people share. So today, let's talk about the 1970s, I had, you know, 20 friends. I used to go and hang out with them. I used to go for a movie, and we used to just, you know, chill out together. And today, a large part of your time spent is on the computer. So how do you give that same experience which a person had in the 70s today, when the person is not actually going out at all? That is where social media comes in. They're actually extending your life online. So I think there is definitely a huge, you know, market going ahead, not just the areas which I mentioned, but going forward a lot of more undiscovered areas as well. So I think I'll start with the second question first. Your story is one of the biggest, I think the biggest entrepreneurship portal in the country. And as a VC, it's definitely very important for me from a deal sourcing perspective, from understanding what sort of trends are going on, what the latest trends are in the industry. The entrepreneur's viewpoint, because your story actually gives a platform to entrepreneurs to voice their opinion. I think there are definitely a lot other websites as well, but I think in terms of coverage, in terms of actually reaching out to the maximum number of entrepreneurs, your story has done a marvelous job. And as I said, not just me, I've spoken to other friends in the venture capital industry as well. And all of us have the same opinion that when it comes to entrepreneurship, when it comes to trends in the industry, when it comes to entrepreneurs voicing their opinion, when it comes to creating a platform between or an intermediary between investors, entrepreneurs and other stakeholders in the system, I think your story is a wonderful, wonderful platform for that. And going back to the first question, I think my only advice to the entrepreneurs is this, that at the end of the day, your idea will change. And that is a fact of life. In fact, some of the biggest incubation cells, some of the biggest venture capital funds which you see today, the focus there is, of course, idea is important and how smart you are is important. But at the end of the day, what really matters is how determined and how flexible you are to change. Because your idea will change. your smartness will determine in which direction is a change required, and your determination will decide how far you go in terms of execution. Because I'm sure as entrepreneurs probably know this better than me, ultimately it's all about execution. An idea is an important component, but just one piece of the puzzle. So yeah, I think beyond the idea, which has to be good, you as an entrepreneur also need to, you know, have that mindset where you know that come what may, I'll execute this and I'll be successful.